Welcome to Institute of Quality and Reliability. Hi, this is Hemant. Have you come across a situation when your development sample was good, but the production lot got rejected? One of the reasons why this happens is incorrect tolerances when we design parts. In this video, we will explain how to estimate tolerance interval using tolerance factors and also using Minitab software. Let us look at a typical new product development cost curve. I am showing a double hump camel, and the cost curve is amazingly similar to the shape of the camel. This is due to incorrect tolerances, poor design, inadequate validation, in general, inadequate resources in the initial phases of the project. We spend significant resources to fix these problems due to poor design and development practices, which is the second hump of the camel. While developing new products or in some other situations, product and process designers often think of natural tolerance limits, which contains certain percentage of the distribution. Typical values of percentage of the distribution are 90 or 95 or 99. If the quality characteristic is normally distributed and we know the population parameters mu and sigma, then the tolerance limits can be easily estimated using normal distribution tables or using Microsoft Excel. However, in real life, during product and process development, we have smaller samples and we do not know the population parameters. We need to make estimates from the available sample data. We will now see how to estimate tolerance intervals when we have only sample data. Statisticians have suggested tolerance factor K2 for two-sided and K1 for one-sided tolerance limits for a given confidence level gamma and specified percentage of the distribution. Typical values of gamma could be 0.9, 0.95 or 0.99. Tables of factors of K1 and K2 are available based on values of gamma and percentage distribution. The practical meaning of two-sided factor K2 is that if we take large number of samples from the population, 100 into gamma percent of the samples will include at least the specified percentage of the distribution between a two-sided tolerance interval given by x bar plus or minus K2 into sample standard deviation. Similarly, upper and lower tolerance interval is given by x bar plus k1 standard deviation and x bar minus k1 standard deviation respectively. Note that population mean and sigma are replaced by sample average x bar and sample standard deviation s. Let us now see an application example. A foundry has sampled hardness of 15 cylinder head castings. Cylinder head is a typical component used in diesel engines. The quality engineer finds that the average hardness is 230 Brinell hardness number or BHN and standard deviation is 20 BHN. Assuming normal distribution, estimate two-sided tolerance limits such that 99% of the distribution will lie within these limits with a probability or confidence level of 0.95. Let us see how is Brinell hardness measured. Brinell hardness is estimated by pressing a very hard material ball against the surface and measuring the diameter of the indentation. Now let us understand how to use the tables for the given problem. Average x bar is equal to 230 Standard deviation of the 15 samples S is 20. Confidence level gamma is 95% or 0.95. Proportion P is equal to 99% or 0.99. We now use tables of tolerance factor K2 as we want two-sided tolerance limits. Remember that the tolerance limits are given by x bar plus or minus K2 into standard deviation S. This slide shows the table of the tolerance factor K2. In the problem, we have been given gamma, that is confidence level of 95%. So choose the confidence level of 95%. We have also been given that we want to have 99% of the population included. The sample size is 15. So now we can see that the factor K2 equals 3.878. In the application example, the sample average X bar was given as 230 and sample standard deviation S was 20. Confidence level specified was 95% or 0.95 and proportion P to be included of the distribution was 99% or 0.99. From the tables of tolerance factor K2 was seen as 3.878. So the tolerance limit can be calculated as x bar plus or minus K2S, that is 230 plus or minus 3.878 into 20, which works out to be 152.44 and 307.56. Therefore, we can say with 95% confidence that 99% or most of the cylinder heads will have hardness between 152 to 358. We can also solve this problem using Minitab software. Let us see how to use Minitab to estimate the tolerance intervals. We use the stat quality tools tolerance intervals command, and in the dialog box we select summarize data. The sample size is 15, sample mean is 230, standard deviation is 20. In options, we can select the confidence level as 95, the default value. Minimum percentage of population in interval is 99 and it's a two-sided interval. So we click OK to get the values of tolerance intervals as 152.294 and 307.706. These are slightly different than the table values. We will now see another application example, and this is of one-sided tolerance limit. A new fuel pump is being developed by a supplier. The supplier has given 10 pumps with the development specifications suggested by research and development design team. The readings of the brake specific fuel consumption, generally referred as BSFC, of the 10 vehicles using these pumps are shown in the table. Based on this data, what upper production tolerance should be specified for BSFC that will include 99% vehicles with 95% confidence level? We can easily calculate mean of the 10 values as 250 and standard deviation is 3.8. So n is equal to 10, x bar is equal to 250 and s is equal to 3.8. We use table of factor K1 for one-sided normal tolerance limits. As shown before, the table can be downloaded from our website as shown here, www.world-class-quality.com. From the table of K1 factor, for sample size of 10, confidence level of 95% and 99% distribution to be included, factor K1 can be seen as 3.981. Thus, upper tolerance for BSFC will be x bar plus K1S, that is 250 plus 3.981 into 3.8, which works out to be 265.12. The meaning of this is, most of our engines, that is 99% of our engines using these fuel pumps, will have fuel consumption less than this value, and this will be true for most of our samples, that is 95% of our samples. Now try this exercise. A company manufactures radiators. Quality engineer has sampled 25 radiator tubes randomly. Average burst pressure was found to be 35 kg per millimeter square and standard deviation was 3 kg per mm square. Assuming normal distribution, estimate the minimum tolerance limit such that 99% of the tubes would lie above this limit with a probability of 0.99. Answer is given here. If you want to solve the problem using tables, the tables of tolerance factors can be downloaded from our website www.world-class-quality.com. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you found it worth watching. Please subscribe to Institute of Quality and Reliability channel if you want to watch more videos on reliability engineering, Six Sigma and statistical quality control. Click on the subscribe and notify buttons on YouTube channel.